brand new trial looked at the effects of exercise on skin health, and they compared two types of exercise, cardio and weight training. Cardio was 30 minutes on a stationary bike, plus a couple minutes of warm-up and cool-down. The weights program was a quick warm-up and then six exercises: leg curl, leg extension, arm curl, rowing, shoulder press, and chest press. Three sets of 10 reps for each exercise. We'll come back to this in the end because I have some questions about this comparison. So they took their participants, roughly 60 people, all women, middle-aged, healthy overall, but sedentary, and they split them randomly. Half did the cardio workout for 4 months, and the other half did the weights. And in both groups, they only worked out twice a week, so it wasn't that intense. They also refrained from any other exercise, and they didn't change their diet or their skincare routine. That way, the exercise programs of the trial were the only variable. Okay, so what happened? First, they saw some overall changes that were expected. The group doing the cardio improved their aerobic capacity and lost a little bit of weight. And the group doing the weights increased their strength and lean mass. So that's a good reality check to make sure they're actually doing the exercises and everything is as expected. What about their skin? The investigators used three measures of skin health. The first was skin elasticity, basically how fast it snaps back into shape after it's stretched. You might have seen people do this pinch test, right? The second measure was skin density, measured with an ultrasound, especially the upper dermis. And the third measure was skin thickness, also focusing on the dermis. These three metrics are often used as biomarkers of skin health and vitality. And in fact, these metrics tend to go down as we age. So they tested all three of these metrics in the participants' facial skin, the cheek. And both groups, both people doing the cardio and people lifting weights, saw improvements for skin elasticity and skin density. So better than before the trial, but only people doing the weightlifting saw improvements in skin thickness. So the weightlifting seemed to provide an extra benefit beyond the cardio. What would be amazing is if they had a third group doing both cardio and weights, so we can see if the benefits are additive. But unfortunately, they didn't have that. We're going to look at caveats of the study in a second, and there's a few. But on the face of it, I think this is an interesting result and not that intuitive. When we think of lifting weights, we think of increasing our strength, getting bigger muscles, maybe improving our posture, not skin health. It's not the first thing that comes to mind when we think about pumping iron. Okay, so how does lifting weights lead to better skin? The researchers propose what's called a mechanistic model, basically an explanation of which molecules might be causing this. There are several molecules that make up the scaffold of our skin. One example is a molecule called biglycan. It's a proteoglycan, and it's a structural component of skin. And biglycan levels drop with age, and they also drop with sun exposure. Also, if you take lab animals and you tweak their genetics to lower their biglycan levels, their skin gets thinner, kind of like what we see during aging. So using a set of molecular experiments, the researchers figured out that weightlifting reduces circulating levels of inflammatory factors that normally inhibit the production of biglycan. So by reducing these inflammatory factors, biglycan production is allowed to go back up. And the idea is that this would then improve skin thickness. In practice, it's always really hard to nail these mechanistic models in humans, because you're very limited in the interventions that you can do with human volunteers, right? But this is the mechanistic model based on their evidence. Now, bear in mind that both cardio and lifting weights affect some of these skin structural molecules. Some are affected by both of them, and some are affected by just one of them. So only weights affect biglycan, cardio doesn't, but cardio affects some other molecules that weightlifting does not. So this is another reason that I think it would be really nice to have a third group doing both cardio and weights because the benefit might be even bigger. Okay, let's talk about some of the caveats. The trial didn't assess the actual appearance of the women's skin. These functional tests are fine, but at the end of the day, people want their skin to look better. They want to look younger. So do these metrics, the thickness of the dermis and the elasticity, actually result in a more youthful look in these women as a result of the physical activity? This trial can't answer that question. Also, it's one trial with 60 people over a few months. So you always want to see the result reproduced in more people, ideally over a longer time span. Another question I have is regarding the duration. I think the weightlifting program is going to take longer, like each exercise session. To do 3 sets of 6 exercises, I think, is going to take longer than the cardio session. Although most of that time might actually be resting time in between sets. So there might theoretically be a confounder there of different time spent exercising. So TBD, something to be elucidated in future work. Another important question is context. How does a new study fit into a research field? There was some previous research suggesting that exercise was good for the skin. There was a trial published a few years back, but they only looked at cardio. And in that trial, they actually looked at the skin of the participants, specifically the buttocks. So I guess the cheeks also, in a way, different cheeks. And it was all men in that trial, also sedentary. And when they started jogging or cycling a few times a week, there were some positive changes to their skin, kind of similar to the tests in this study. So this new trial supports those previous findings regarding the benefit of exercise to skin health, and it adds new information by suggesting that lifting weights might be even better than cardio. When it comes to fighting skin aging, there are a few factors that are well established and supported by evidence. Managing UV exposure, what's called photoaging, not smoking, and hydration. Those are 3 prominent examples. The evidence is now mounting that exercise might also belong on that list. And if future work confirms these results, adding some weight training to our workout might be good not just for our muscles, but also for the skin covering them. Here's more information on diet and exercise, including protein timing, carbohydrate intake, etc. And here's a video about longevity and how to maximize it using science. I'll see you over there.